Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Alice Fiction on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Alice Fiction and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Alice Fiction. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all buddies, to start we need to launch our main browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's go to that URL I have highlighted in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen. You don't need to type it. Simply because there's the clickable link in the description of this video and the first main comment. We landed there on our own site of Usitility, in which we find here a precise explanation on how to obtain Alice Fiction on personal computer. We scroll lower a tad and then click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on this link, we reach the site of BlueStacks. No panic, it is simply the Android emulator that we will load to get access to the game Alice Fiction on PC. As you can discover from here, we access several pros of preferring using the emulator. Now we are ready to start downloading the Alice Fiction by simply clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. Next step is clicking on this button. And the download takes no time at all. Voila! Here is located the download. It is an executable file. What we are going to do now is to run the executable file. So we have to click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to allow modifications to the laptop or device. We clicked yes. I minimize the internet browser to start to see the installation software considerably better. The installer is straightforward. It is made up of a couple of possibilities: install and setup path. I will describe what setup path really does. We merely click it, and now we note that we got here the path where in fact the emulator can be set up. If we would like to modify this directory, we have got to click on that browse option. Therefore we opt for another folder and install the emulator wherever we prefer. I prefer to leave it where it is. I click on back, so I just click install. Voila, the setup commences and it is going to commence in the download of those megabytes that are represented on this computer screen. The time you download it, it might possibly be a little bit more or less MB. The download rate can be faster or at a lower speed, based on your type of access to the web and depending on the speed of the emulator web servers. Today they are progressing very fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this moment, the emulator happens to be started successfully. As you can observe, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar which will move forward to the right, and once it attains the end, the emulator will be started for the first time. The truth is the emulator has been started, there for the very first time. Before we carry on, as you will notice, it created a couple of app icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon will be the one we're concerned with. The moment we need to start Alice Fiction on our desktop or laptop, we twice mouse click on this app icon and as a result run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Why don't we conduct the next phase, which is actually a must-have, and this is to begin browsing the Google Play Store. And we'll just click on Play Store. As you can observe, the Google Play is started. At this point we are required to log on. At this point once we're on this page, we must definitely execute the next step which is imperative. So that we just click on Sign In. At this moment it shows checking info. It might once in a while get stopped at checking info, that's why it doesn't move ahead. If that's the case, you may attempt to connect to your account. After a number of hours it's going to most likely be repaired. At this moment we're going to provide our email address and password. The email address needs to be a Gmail email and its matching password. As an example, you can utilize the same exact email you're using right now in your own YouTube account. So that I will enter my details and I will go back as soon as I have done it. That's it, info typed. Discover Google welcoming us and supplying us their terms of service. We will agree to all of them by simply pressing, I agree. Following, it make us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You can also keep it selected and it'll produce a backup of your data files on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to select it, you do what you want. We just click on accept. Google Play Store is started without need to open it manually and completely on its own. To set up the application, we must visit the emulator desktop by simply clicking the app icon indicated green colored. Right now that we are discovering the desktop of that emulator for Android, we notice that we find right here the install video game button. We simply click on this button. There we have got the Android game. Let's just click now on the install option that I am highlighting now in green color. And this will commence the software setup. Straight away it would download and install the video game. It might take quite some time or perhaps it might well be almost immediate. It again all is subject to on our connection to the internet. It's by then finished setting up. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by clicking this specific option I'm emphasizing in green, so that you can run Alice Fiction for the first time. We're now on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're preparing to just click that new Alice Fiction icon that was provided. This game app is started for the very first time. So there we end up with it. I could click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should discuss the sound level of that emulator. This is right here. We have got the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This way we do not count on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of your emulator. And to take pleasure in the experience to the greatest, we will activate the large monitor, for which we have two options. This is actually the very first one. We mouse click on that app icon that I'm mentioning in green color. And the monitor is maximized, experiencing one border on top, one at the right and one at the bottom. In the event that we would like to play the application using all the screen, we mouse click on this particular app icon. And we might presently be experiencing and enjoying the Android game in 100% screen setting. To leave the full screen setting, hit the F11 key. Then we would certainly currently play in standard display screen mode. At present, I am choosing to explain you the computer keys mapping and that is certainly quite exciting. This strategy we will probably be in a position to play the game application far more easily. The very first point is to press this keyboard icon. It's now time to complete the recommended controls. I'll go ahead and keep the default configuration. However, if you really want to adjust this, you may very well do this without any problem. Perhaps you have realized, the emulator is entirely in our own language. Once in a while it occurs that your emulator is started in the incorrect language, for example, in Japanese. And therefore to place it in the appropriate language we click here to the cogwheel. Then there throughout many other controls, we just click that language drop down. We may opt for the language we like, Italian, Mandarin, and so forth. As soon as the language is determined, we are going to save, the emulator would reboot, and also the game application, the next time we use it, would of course be in the selected language. At this point, you can find another thing that we have to take into consideration, and this is that we will receive a message from Gmail indicating that a completely new equipment has been associated with this Google account. It will definitely check with us if we are the people who have associated with that electronic device. Yes, we really should not worry, considering the fact that emulator is emulating an Android electronic device. In order to find which tablet or smartphone is currently being emulated, we come back right here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. And so we browse here to the model selection. And now we observe that the emulator is simulating a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for our video user demo. I sincerely hope you appreciated it, particularly that you found it informative. If that's so, allow it a pleasant thumb up, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer your remarks, issues or ideas, leave them in the comment area below. You could possibly also leave a comment on my Twitch channel, I do live streams every now and then, you get it below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Just click any of the video tutorials that happens to be appearing on the computer screen and see you in the following video tutorials. Bye.